opportunity for those in the area who are music educators, a place for them to show how they really use their talents in many ways. But so often, and many of my friends are music educators, and they have private studios, or they teach in a local high school or a local middle school or someplace. They direct a band or a choir, and we don't often get to hear them perform on an instrument that they had trained on for so many years. So that's really how the Chime Concert came to be. We want to give them an opportunity to have a stage for just a few minutes, so much easier for them than just putting together a recital or concert on their own. So we're very glad tonight. We start with a couple of baritones, and they're just wonderful. They're marvelous together. I think that probably their friendship is what really makes their sound so great. And we have Miss Ann Mullenbach to accompany them. We have Jim Bolger and Alan Bruce. They will be performing together. And in fact, Al is one of our instructors. He teaches low brass here for us as well. So that will be our first group. And then we have Carl Weinberger. Are you next?
And Tricia. Yeah,
Tricia. All right. Well, in second will be Tricia Martin. You may have heard her. She's been with us before. She has a private piano studio, and she is a marvelous pianist. We're thrilled to have her back. We're thrilled to have Carl back. Carl Weinberger, he brings to us his classical guitar, and we always get comments from the students about how they love hearing that, because they don't often hear that quality, this caliber of music, of guitar. They hear themselves in their bedroom, I think, is what they're used to. And then finally, bringing up the rear, as it were, is our very own jazz director, Paul Zuckerman, and we never know what will come from his performance. So thank you for being here, and enjoy.
The piece we're going to play tonight is originally written for a trumpet duet. We're playing it as a baritone duet, obviously. It's the type of song that would have been played at the turn of the 1800s, early 1900s. It's the type of music that would have been played by Sousa's band. If you would have gone to a town band concert in the town square, this is the type of piece you would have heard that would have been featuring some trumpets. So this is the Two Friends. Thank you.
Thank you. classical musicians memorize all their music, and I've always been jealous of everybody else who doesn't. So I'm going to play this one with the music because I'm also getting older. Try to figure out what's on my mind. And this last one is a Chopin waltz, and I'm going to dedicate this to Tom and Bert Paninsky, because one time I saw them waltz and I thought, I want to waltz like that.
Thank you. So when I was asked to do this evening, I thought I'd play some TV themes. I have a whole book of them here. I'm not going to play them all. I originally was going to try and do about 30 of them, because they're short. But I thought I'd concentrate on a few, and I picked a few composers. The first one here is Johnny Mandel. And he also wrote songs like Shadow of Your Smile. And this is going to be the theme from MASH. So these guys that do these songs managed to come up with a nice, simple, catchy movie or TV theme, but they're also capable of filling an entire half hour, hour, or in some cases, 2 hour movie with just reams of music. So I think they're legitimate composers. So this is. Thank you very much. words for that were written by a 15-year-old, Mike Altman, who was the son of the director of the MASH movie, Robert Altman. Robert Altman made $70,000 for directing the movie. His kid has made over $1 million writing the words for that song. So that's another Johnny Mandel theme, or song. Thank you. got notes and wrote them to play it. I thought that was pretty good for a song like that. I'm going to go on this song. It's Earl Hagen, who also played Benny Goodman and Tommy Dorsey, and there's been tons of things. And Everett Sloan wrote the lyrics for this song. I can't whistle very good, so I'm going to sing the song. Although we are trying to teach our bird to do it, aren't we?
Thank you. Thank you. solo mio. My show, I do what I want. Okay. Perfect. That was My Romance by Rodgers and Hart. Here's a Chick Corea song. This is called Crystal Silence, and I haven't played this since 1982 at my sophomore DePaul University recital. I hope I remember it. If not, you won't know. Thank you. I'd like to do a song now. It's not in the program, but Sheboygan lost an important cog in its wheel this week. Tim DeFore passed away, and many of you know or knew Tim, and those of you who knew him well knew that he was a heck of a blues harmonica player. Matter of fact, when he first started his business, the first five people he hired were all musicians. And instead of quitting at 5 o'clock like most 9-to-5 button-down type operations, they quit at 4, and then they went down to the basement and played the blues for an hour before everybody left. And I would like to do a quick blues song for our buddy Tim. This is one that he always used to enjoy sitting in with us when he would come out and sit in with us. This is in the key of G, for those of you with scorecards. Smiling with your lipstick on a mask.
that life was awful tame. When I took you to the nightclub, the whole band knew your name.
Down in the land of dreams, you never know how nice I'm.
Our new friends, Jim Bolger, because I hadn't met him before, but what a sweet man, and Al Bruce, and of course, well, they're not here anymore, I don't suppose. Oh, there's Jim!
And in honor of our 50th anniversary,
hold on, except, here comes Al. Here comes Tricia.
Except for Tricia Martin, we're all 50.
Yes, hold on, you're taking my jokes.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Is Ann here? We selected our
she had another gig.
Gentlemen. Who were all born in 1964. And Ms. Tricia represents our first graduating class, born in 1984 herself.
Or thereabouts.
Or thereabouts, that's right, that's right. So let's have another round of applause. Thank you so much for coming.